Greetings for today's video. I promised you every Wednesday. Well, today's Tuesday, so you'll get it out. I'm going to be doing my good friend who I graduated from high school with. So it's going to be fun because we're going to do a complete Jane Iredale makeup today using brushes and all of her new products. And I hoped you learned something and like what we're going to do. So let me introduce you to my buddy Lyle.
Hello.
And so let's get going. The first thing I'm going to do on her is I have this wonderful hydration, and I'm going to take some hydration into her skin. It's not Jane Iredale, but I just want to make sure. It's one of my Korean things that we use on our body, and so I just want her skin absolutely perfect. And we're going to go through a lot of things today. Again, working with mature makeup. And okay, we'll let that set. I have to put my mic on. We hit it. Let me get this. Okay, so we're going to let this set. Now I'm going to do two things here because I want to show you my favorite Jane Iredale product. And this is something that I discovered when I first got the line in before COVID, and I had never seen anything like it. And this is called their Liquid Minerals. And they look so weird. And I thought, what is this? You know, I had never seen in my career, I had never seen anything like it. Well, what this is a tinted serum. So people that were wearing masks, their skin was getting dry. I think this is all I sold through that, and I continue to sell it. Because what it does, it doesn't have sunscreen in it, but there's a little bit of tint in it. And it has hyaluronic acid base, and it kind of just shoots little spurts throughout the day to hydrate your skin. And this has been a fabulous primer. And so I'm going to use this today so you can all, and this is for your non-makeup people. And that's why I want to show it. Because this might be the answer to you, you know, starting your journey back into wearing something and making your skin look better. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of this, and I have to put my glasses on. And when it comes out, it kind of looks cottage cheesy. And why it looks like that is because of, get my sponge on here, is because the minerals and the little color spurs are breaking up. So you can put it on with your fingers, but I'm just going to put a light coat. And all over, but this just diffuses your pores. And you can go online with Jane Iredale and do the foundation quiz on there. It'll tell you what colors you wear, but I have found with this, boy, you can wear so many different colors. So I'm just this is a great moisturizer for during the day. So we're just kind of going in, and I'm going to take a little bit of sponge. And I know when I first started selling it, I had a few return. They says, I don't think it's good. I think it's kind of cottage cheesy. But that's exactly how it is. But after it's set, oh, it's so nice. So I want you to see, I'm going to use our new foundation today, but I want you to see how nice of a finish that is to her skin just with the liquid foundations. And a lot of times I will use this as a primer. I've started using it as a primer with my Saint because it really works well. So that's the first thing we did. I'm going to let it kind of set. The color that I used on her was suntan. Maybe caramel. No, I think suntan's the good one. So that's, I'm going to let that set in. The next thing I'm going to do is I need to work some corrector in here, into our little ditches that we all have. And, okay, I have it. Let me get my concealer brush. I guess I don't have it right here. And I'm also going to this is my Circle Delete 2, and they're correctors. So I'm going to take some of the orangier color, and I'm just going to put it right here in this blue area. Let's see if I've got the right color here. I might have to take a little bit deeper one. Let me see. This is okay. This is the fun of doing live, because you can see what different things I'm working with. So I'm going to go a little bit orangier into this, into the let's see. Sometimes you just have to warm it up and work it in with your finger, especially with the correctors. There we go, we're getting it. All right, what a difference that does. And you want to start with a corrector before you put your makeup on. And I usually use my concealers afterwards when I'm done with all my eyes and so forth. I'm going to take a little bit more. I'm kind of mixing a whole bunch of these together right in that well. Let me see if I can use it. This is also a great the corrector kit. This might even work better where I don't have to blend. I love this because it gives you four different types of concealers for the price of one, but you have different things to work on your face if you have high pigmentation or, and of course we have to go in our little wells here, our special little dents. All right. I think what I'm gonna do too is use this as a concealer. I need a base for her eyelid, so I'm going to have you close your eye and see we have discoloration. I think we all have this. And then I'm going to, after I do this, I'm going to set it with some setting powder. And right now, Jane Iredale, their eye primer is being reformulated and is not available, but we'll look forward to a new something even better coming out. So back to the old school of of using our concealers and correctors. Again, I'm just using my finger to warm that up. And this is another, this is, I tell my clients all the time, this is great because it can, you can just use your concealers. Okay, so what we did is we put our liquid minerals on, and then we neutralized the eyelid. Well, if you didn't want to do anything else, you could put a little bit of blusher and mascara, and you got it made for the day for just, I know I'm just dotting these in here.
Find my imperfections.
Uh-huh. Okay, now I'm going to introduce you guys to the new Jane Iredell foundation. And this has just now come out. This is called, this is the Glow Time Pro. Now we had Glow Time before, and it only had about a 15% sunscreen in it, but this has 25 and it's broad spectrum, so there's no chemicals in this at all. I don't know which color we're going to use yet, but I'm going to try them both. You use very little of this, very little. There's 14 colors, and I'm using on her right now, I'm trying to see which one's between 7 and 8. And I just got these in, so all right, let me get another brush here. Since my other one's all wet, so I'm gonna go over. I've used, okay, let me see, this one wins, so just going to, I mean, a little bit goes a long ways. I mean, you can't even take a real heavy squirt out of it. It's, there's enough. You can put it on with a brush. You can put it on with a, I'm using a dense brush that's angled, and Jane Iredell has lots of ones, but I just used it for my other. To putting her liquid minerals on, so I need two of them. So I haven't used maybe a half a pump of this new Pro, and you can see how much I have left. I'm going to just tap a little bit in, and but look at the finish on that. So we're just going to let that melt into the skin, and then we're going to take a look at it a little bit later. And I don't think we'll have to do any powdering. I'm not a big powderer, but if we had to, we'll worry about after that melts into the skin. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to, let's see, looking pretty good there, my dear. Okay, I'm going to set her, I'm going to be using a couple different palettes today of Jane Iredell's new shadows. The first thing I want to do is I want to set her lid. So I'm just going to go into this color, the second color. Let me tell you what it is. Oh, I don't know. Silk. This is basics. Use your head, is it? And I'm just going to set it. And this is going to give us a good canvas for our shadow. Because I used the concealer to use as my prep and my eye prep. So I'm going to let this just kind of set in, and then I'm going to work on her brows. I'm not going to do any of her blushers or anything right now because I usually make a mess. So I did put my, I did right here. I'm going to be using today Jane Iredale's, let's see, I need her. There's a little brush in there, but I'm going to be using, this is brunette. And then this is like a gel or what would you call it? Just to kind of like a setting gel. So I'm just going to take the side and I'm going to, I want to put this in. Oh, this one might be too dark for her. Yeah. Let's go with a more of a blonde. And I'm using just a real dense, stiff brush. So let's put these in. Let me.
I lost half of that one.
Oh, okay.
I don't know why.
Let me brush this up. Yeah, that's a much better color. This is ash blonde. But when a more mature eye, you want to make sure, you know, that we're lifting this outer part, because this is where we start, that hood joins us, makes us very special. Okay. So, again, I work it up here, as in kind of drawn in, and I'm doing this real fast just for video. But this works a lot better. You can also use your eyeshadows. You can use, it's just using the right brush and all right, I need to lift this a little bit more on this side. All right, now let's see if we have, and right now they kind of look like they're too dark. Well, that's because we're just kind of, we can always soften them later, but they're gonna set in with, all right, let's see right here. So I'm not going to set them yet with the this other whatever it's called over here. the dilly, the white dilly thing. All right. But this is again, like I showed you in my mistake, the five mistakes on mature eyes. This is number one. People just leave their brows alone and they don't stop. So, you know, everything's coming down on them. All right, so that's there. The next thing I want to do, this feels good. Okay. Is I'm going to do some liner on her. And well, there are several ways we can do this. Where's that fabulous brush that I had? I think I'm just going to come in. All right, let me think. Let me think this out here. We have liquid eyeliner, so
it's been a long time.
It's been a long time, yes. But this is Jane Iredale, and but I want to take this and I want to get really close to the eyelid. She's got a natural eye. Okay, look down. So I'm just going to lay this on top of those lashes, and like I had said before, it's kind of hard as we get older to use the pencils because they make too fat of a line. And Let me see what we're doing. Let me go back in here a little bit more. But you want to position your hand on your face. And I'm going to kind of make this a little fat at the end. I'm going to kind of just wing this up. All right. Because I'm going to, there's a method to my madness here. All right. It's been a long time since we've used liquid eyeliners, but they're really, with the style in makeup, they really come back strong, especially the gels. They're nice. Let me see if I've got you pretty even. Look down. To leave a line like this is not attractive, but we're putting this in there for depth, for her, to make her shadows. Her lashes look thicker because they, you know, as we more mature, they get so thin. So I'm going to diffuse this once I start working on. Now she's got a liner underneath, and I'm also going to diffuse that because if you're going to have your makeup tattooed, you don't want a line tattooed underneath as we get older. You want one maybe dotted about a third of the way over. But in this case, because what happens is we start our line, our eye starts drooping down here because of the fat loss, and then it'll close off the eye. So what are we gonna do here? Okay, let me grab my brushes and I'm going to take this peach. I want to see what this peach is going to do. And I want to come right up here. I love a good soft pink. It just is refreshing to start with that hood. And I'm using a whatever brush. It's Jane Iredale. And it's not real stiff. It's like a eyeshadow fluff. Again, we might have to start putting video on the bottom so you know what I'm saying. What I'm gonna now look at me. Okay, she's got large eyes, which is everybody kills for. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a soft, like I said, I'm working out of two palettes here. One is called Pure Basics and one is Naturally Matte. So I want to look, I want you to look down. I'm going to take this soft brown. And when you're holding your brushes, if you get close to the barrel, you're going to get more application. If you hold it back here, you're going to get a fluffier. So I'm just taking this color here, this soft brown, and working it in. And I want to lift that out. And again, I'm holding the brush at toward the end. So you can see what we've started here. Okay. And a lot of times you'll see me teach where I teach the triangle here. I know with myself, it's almost better to do like a V here, a sideways V. Okay, let me do this side. Let's see, I'm kind of playing with two colors. I kind of introduced this one in here, which is a little bit more of a russet brown, because I, you know, sometimes you can look too brown. Okay, let's see. Then I'm going to work it up. Yeah, I like that. Okay. And of course, we always have one eye that's different than the other. Okay. And I'm working that side of that brush. I'm letting it just diffuse that and lift that up. So we're just kind of creating this to lift that outer eye. And again, we don't want to leave that space between where our hood is. We just don't want it to stop and have white above it. All right, so we're kind of matching. Clean my brush here. Let's see, what else do we want? I'm taking a little bit of this soft brown, and I'm sorry, I don't know the colors. They're brand new. I just got them in, so I haven't learned all the colors, but they're written on the back of the palette. And all right, I need a little bit more brow pencil here. Brow. All right. Okay, do we look matched? Someone with good eyes. Uh-huh. So now I'm going to change brushes here. And I'm going to pull in a very dense, a dense flat. I can have this one. And I'm going, let's see, I want to look at her eye and see the pretty colors in it. This has got some plum. Let's see what this plum does. First of all, I'm going to take a little bit of this. So you can see how we have smudged this out. Let me get my smudge brush. So that line that she has on the bottom doesn't look so defined. And it's much, much softer. And it's a really pretty blue, so she can... So then I'm going to have her look down. I'm going to take a little bit of purple. And remember, I was talking about that little C shape. And this is where we can, you know, they tell us we can't work color and we can't do this. Well, you can do anything you want. Just don't listen to the, they haven't gotten old yet, you know, so I'm better telling you that. Most of the people on our makeup videos, they haven't worked in studios and as working on as many people as we've worked in as professional makeup artists. So I'm just taking that and I'm working it. And that's pretty. But she could take this outer corner and she could do her blues and her greens and her teals and just, you just don't want to go all over the lid with it and look like a tropical fish. Yeah. So, and that's, you know, back in that days, when Lyle and I were in high school, we used to have what we called, what was it? Yardley paints. And we used to just garb ourselves up and we wore the twiggies and we really got with it. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing I did with the bottom, is I'm going to kind of diffuse that line that I put in. But I needed the depth of that dark to of the eyeliner. And even if you decided to use a pencil or a gel pencil or whatever, it's just smudging this out. See, that's really looking pretty, and we're lifting this way. So that's why I've come into the corner here. And, but let me see. So see how that eye's kind of taken a more dramatic look? We can be dramatic if we want. And even if you just put one color on there just to, so here, now the trick is to match this. Well, maybe we don't need to. All right, let's try something. Let me get that C in there. And you can just use the tip of that, you know, see how that's shaped? You can just dot it in there like that. And even with your eyeliner, if you were using your eyeshadow as your eyeliner, you can just dot it in there like this. I think I showed that on her, I did her daughter last week. All right. Let me get this all blended. And that plum, she's got a lot of hazel in her eye. And it's just enhancing, instead of wearing just because you have, brown eyes. That purple is gonna, purple brown, is going to enhance that more. So again, I'm going to come. All right, we need to diffuse this a little. I'm kind of just dip it into both. A little bit of brown, a little bit of plum. What do we have? All right. And even if, let's say she wanted to look a little bit fancier, she was going someplace. We could put a lash on her, but what I would do is a lash on the, I'm not going to put it on there because I don't do them very well. I can't see. But, okay, I'm going to work on her brow a little on the end. Okay. Because as you see, I'm missing it. But I am going to lift it out a little bit more. Yep, now we got her going. All right, let's see what this goop does. I'm gonna just kind of put that in there like that. And this is gonna set it so it stays during the day. So there we go, we have it happening. What I want to do right now, okay, because you can tell that I have a lot of cleanup here, is I want to take, okay, where's my sponge? I'm going to take a fun color. Let's see what else I have. I want a... Oh, yes. Look at this. This is called Naturally Glam. Okay. She didn't know I was going to really gob her up today.
No.
But that's okay.
It's okay.
So I'm going to take my finger and I'm going to just dab it. And if you try to use a brush... And this is where we can write on, just like somebody has put a spot, you know, just is right to the windows to our soul. Oh, unless ours left, huh? What do you think?
It's dark in there.
Uh-huh.
Pretty.
Yeah, you can see, and it's almost better to do it with your finger and then kind of blend it in. But see what that's doing? That's really setting and making those eyes come forward. So we think we have a hood. Okay. She really came out with some wonderful new palettes this year. And you get quite a bit in there. And they're all coordinated. So now before I do anything else, I want to do her concealer. Okay, where is what I was going to use? Right here. I'm going to use Disappear. It's a full coverage concealer. And I'm kind of just warming it up. And I'm going to and do my kind of cleanup that way. I don't think that's the right color. Let's see, what is this? Medium dark? Let me grab something else here. So I'm just doing a little bit of cleanup. Like I said, I always like to, and I've just learned this as I just started maturing in the last couple years. Yeah, 71, I guess. I've been just trying to learn more about problems that I've had with my makeup and why they're doing what. And I've learned that I just need to, I'm not getting a good coverage on that. So we have to pull out something else. Okay, we'll see what else we have. The new Jane Iredale came out with a fabulous new concealer in Lighten Plus, but the problem was is none of the applicators worked. I mean, it's the most fabulous stuff, but I mean, I had to return them all because you couldn't get them to work. And that was, you know, I think everybody that is in the cosmetic business had problems during that time getting the right ingredients in from China. And okay, let me see. I'm thinking out loud here. I'm going to spray my brush with some, well, no, not yet. I have some new things in, and they are my, the new colors for Glow Time for my bronzers and highlighters. And I've kind of picked out some different ones that I thought this is going to be a little bit better. And we're going to do, let's see. And this is easy. And again, it's cream, so I haven't set it yet. I'm going to work it in with my brush. And this is what I've been doing my makeup with the same brush, but it's just kind of blending this in. But you could also use it as a lip, and we do have lip because a lot of my clients, more mature clients, they don't like lipstick anymore because it just runs all over their face. They're working with the newer glosses, the oil glosses, the lip stains. Ooh, are we looking good? I'm going to take a little bit and kind of work it up here. Again, we are lifting. Ooh, are you looking good? Ooh, darling. All right. So, okay. That color that I put on her was glorious. Ooh, glorious. Okay. Now I'm going to take my, this is our bronzer. This is, let's see which one this is. Bronzer's So Bronze. All right. That's what I'm going to work on here. And I'm just going to just dab it in. But bronzers goes where the sun kisses you. Okay. So we're going to come and I'm going to work it a little bit. I'm not giving her real a lot of contouring. Just kind of get it blended down the neck so we don't look like whose head you're wearing. You know? Yeah, where'd you get that head? All right, so look, it's just giving her that look. And it's fresh, and we don't have so many layers. Like I said, we put two layers because I wanted to demonstrate the new Glow Time. But she could have been fine just with the liquid minerals and a little bit on here. So that's that. Then if we she also came out with some wonderful blushers. And let me find a blush brush. If she wanted, you know, just there's all different kinds. If you're used to dry blushers, and these are absolute, they're just like cream. They feel like cream, and we have so many different colors. So I'm just kind of showing you. When you're working, I still see people saying, you know, smile and get the rounds. Well, we don't really have the rounds anymore. I like to wrap it around this way, almost like a paisley. And sometimes what's beautiful is you can use all of Jane Iredell's blushers she got so much on the eyes because they're all pure and they're Green Cosmetics Onycology approved. So you don't have, I'm just going to take this brush, this is called Duvernay, and I'm going to just soften it out this outer edge. These are just tricks. You don't have to do all this. This is just things. And again, we're further lifting and I'm kind of working it almost above the brow to further lift that. So that's another trick. Again, I haven't mastered yet my under eye problem here. Oh, I haven't got the right combination here. I think what I'm going to take is my my liquid minerals, and this is one that's been used, and I'm just going to dot this in just to set what we've done. This is, you know, if anybody can wear let's see. Yes, that's helping a little bit. I have little tiny ones of these that I give to my clients. They're little testers. All right. Yes. I think one of the biggest things my problem was getting away from wearing powders. It was because I just used powders, but I needed to find something that, boy, are you looking pretty. Okay, we are going to put some lash on her, and in my drawers, they should be labeled if I had somebody who could come and label them. All right, I'm going to have, this is one of the greatest products. This is your lash conditioner, and you can wear this at night on your lashes. You can wear it. I'm going to put it on before I put her mascara on. And in fact, what we'll do, I'll just wait till we get this done, and I'll just cut out this part so they don't have to be bored. I mean, everyone knows how to put their mascara on. Okay, I'm going to come in with some mascara. And the one I'm using today is the longest lash. So I'm going to come right down on the tops. And all of her mascara formulations, let me do something here. Would you hand, is there a Kleenex? I hear.
Oh
yeah, there. Okay. Let me get my brush and clean up my mess before it sets in there. All right, close. just can't get this without making a mess. All right, I'm going to have you close your eye. There we go. Okay, now you can open. Let me get a little bit on the bottom. Even if you don't have any on the bottom, by using a softer, like I did with her, a softer shadow color, it rounds out that, almonds out that eye. Okay, let's see. I got it everywhere. All right. Okay, close. I'm going to have to put some more of my sparkly stuff on you. Huh? Uh-huh. I know.
Sparkly stuff.
Uh-huh. Where's my sparkly one? There we go. Now we'll try this again. This might be a little dry. All right. Now, I always have to go back after I get my eyeshadow done. And let me look up, because my eyelids grab, and I find that with more mature eyes, they will start grabbing color. That's why I use a primer, but I will also absorb it, so I might have to balance things out. And I have one eye that absorbs more than the other. All right, so let's kind of balance this out here. And as you can see, all right, she kind of absorbed it, so I'm gonna just do a little bit of touch up here. And I'm using this kind of a redwood color that goes really nice with her. I've just kind of taken her eye color and created a palette. You know, it's like if we went out to the lake and we were going to draw a scene. That's what I've done with her eyes. And, you know, because they just look how pretty they look. You know, we've worked this all in. Close here. And we've got the lights shining, the stadium lights coming down here. I still have this darker over here. All right, I get so picky, working with this. Let me find the right pen, the right brush to do this. Oh, that's what I'm gonna use. I'm gonna use the color I used on her cheeks, that debonair. I'm gonna use it right here to soften this underneath here more. See how that softened that line? You know, it's really nice to have a product line that is so universal that I remember in the olden days, we couldn't use lips on our cheeks and lips on our eyes and because they were so contaminated with bad stuff. But like I have this, you know, I'll show you in just a second. I have this one product that you can do a whole face out of just with one palette. And it's actually a blusher with different colors. I think they're called roses and some are called oh, I'll show them to you. Boy, okay. I just kind of have softened this up. I'm gonna set her makeup now with some lavender, and this just is the best. I gotta do me too. And that is going to set her makeup. And then I will sometimes come back with my sponge, and we have all kinds of sponges. But look how beautiful her skin looks. And honestly, I just started out with my liquid minerals as my primer. And we have primers. We have two different primers. We have a luminous primer and we have a matte primer for the people with oilier skin. And I used like a half a pump of the new Glow Time. And I used, I believe it was 7 or 8 on her. Okay, look at her. She's just looking good. But I think we need a little bit more blusher. All right, now for yips, man.
Ooh.
Lips. Okay, what are we gonna do today? We have, let's see. Let's see what this does. I love her lip pencils, but like I said, I have the best one at home. So I'm gonna take softly, just do a real fine line. And I like to take That's why I like using the lip. I like to use the side of the lip pencil so we don't look so. Was that 80s or 90s where it was just all about looking like a big liner? And I'm using this. so we don't have, yeah, it's very soft. This is called Rose. I mean, she's got beautiful, we've got nudes and roses and all kinds of things. Let's see, I want to use the new, let me find a lip brush. I got some new, these are called lip stains. And of course I have my other lip, whoa. Let's see, I don't think that one worked. This is lip stain and I'm using Buff. The Beyond Matte lip colors are being reformulated. They had a lot of I don't know if I'm getting enough color out of there. Let's see. There we go. But again, this is another area where people haven't been wearing a lot of lip color. They just wanted almost like a stain. I see a lot of them coming out with lip oil, and I've got one of my companies came out with that. I'm not getting enough color here. Okay, so where's my, it's in my hand. Let's go to my, okay, wrong color. All right, here we go.
It's a nice nude lip, though.
It is. And really, that's what everyone wants right now. Mm-hmm. This is our Hydro Pure lip. And this is one, you've heard me talk about this before. I said, well, I don't sell lip glosses because my clients are older. And she says, well, this is great. It doesn't get on your teeth. And that's a little bit better. I don't still have enough color here. I have tricks. Let me get my tricks. Okay. Tricks. Where there's a will, there's a way.
Awesome.
All right. Just going to take a little bit of my lip crayon. We're getting a little bit more color there. I need it browner, but I don't, like I said, I don't have that one with me. It's probably going to be my favorite one. But why I like the crayons is they just, you can use a crayon and then the lip gloss and you really have something. There we go. All right, we probably need more mascara on, but I'll have her do that. But what I want to show you is just a good close-up of her.
We just lean in?
Yeah, lean in and see how beautiful. You want to shut your eyes. Can you see what we did? We came in with this C shape, but we diffused out that line, and we diffused. And everything is lifted, same with her blushers, but doesn't she look beautiful?
Uh-huh. Thank you, Kelly.
Oh, gosh. Everything that I use on today's makeup is on Jane Iredale's, I'm just buffing this out more, on Jane Iredale's website. There is a link on my YouTube. If you go down there, it will direct you to Jane Iredale, and you can do your color match to see what color matches work best for you. And if there's something that you want to order, yes, I do get a percentage of that as my affiliate, but they always have gift with purchases. Every month they have something new that they're promoting. So, and I will list everything that I used on the description of this video. So if you liked it, give me a thumbs up, and don't forget to like and subscribe. And if any of you want to share it with any of your friends, I sure would like it, because I'm stuck at 69 subscribers. I'm getting lots of views, but I would like to know in your comments of what more you want to see, or maybe what you want me to address. Because you all, I don't know if you know this, but I've been a makeup artist for 40 years, and we're all aging a little bit, so I can teach you things that you don't know, or maybe you're having problems with. Thank you for joining me today, and Lyle, thanks so much.
Thank you.